Howdy! I am Professor Curtis of Aspire Mountain Academy, here with more statistics homework help. Today, we're going to learn how to identify and interpret critical R values. Here's our problem statement. For a data set of chest sizes, distance around chest in inches, and weights, pounds, of 12 anesthetized bears that were measured, the linear correlation coefficient is R equals 0.873. Use the table available below to find the critical values of R. Based on a comparison of the linear correlation coefficient R and the critical values, what do you conclude about a linear correlation? Okay, so here we have an icon where we can access the table of critical values for R, so we click that. Here's our table of critical R values. We need to find the number of pairs of data that we have, and we are given that in the problem statement. Right up here where it says 12 anesthetized bears. So 12 is the number that we want to look for. Here's the number 12 in the table. Critical R value is corresponding with 12.576. Now, keep in mind that you have two critical values, one positive and one negative. Only the positive one is listed here in the table. So we go to put our answer in. I'm going to start by putting in this plus or minus sign. You could actually list the answers separately. I think you would take it that way as well. List one negative and then comma and then the other one positive. But I like to make it easy, not type so much. So I'm just going to put in the plus or minus sign and then the value from the actual R table. Well done. Now, the next part of the problem, since the correlation coefficient R is, and then there's a drop-down menu, in the left tail below the negative critical value, in the right tail above the positive critical value, between the critical values. So, in order to understand where we're at, it's helpful to draw out a number line with your critical values and the value of R that's generated by your data. To help us with that, I've actually produce something of a number line here in Excel. So here we can put in our critical R value. So we have one that's negative and one that's positive. Now the question is, where does our R value lie? 0.873 lies in this region here, which is a region of acceptance. So here in this first drop-down menu in our answer fields, we're going to select in the right tail above the positive critical value, and we're in a region of acceptance, so there is sufficient evidence to support the claim of a linear correlation. Excellent! And that's how we do it at Aspire Mountain Academy. Be sure to leave your comments below to let us know how good a job we did or how we can improve. And if your stats teacher is boring or just doesn't care to help you learn stats, go to AspireMountainAcademy.com where you can find out more about accessing our lecture videos or provide feedback on what you'd like to see. Thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.